we're more or less rated by when somebody flushes a commode or pulls a plug for a drain and it leaves their house, or it leaves their building or their dorm, they're happy. That water went someplace. But when it gets here is where, depending on what came down that drain, we're affected by. So what we're trying to do is to take all the contaminants out of the wastewater, and we don't release it to the stream. Penn State is very unique in where we spray irrigate on 518 acres of farm and forestry out towards our airport.
The decision was made by the administration to, why don't we take that water and not put it back into the stream, but apply it to the land and recharge the groundwater, and that's where the system came about. After the water leaves the wastewater treatment plant, after it's been disinfected, it goes into a tank where it's pumped about 2.5 miles out here to the spray areas, and it comes out through pipes that are underground below frost line. Comes onto the spray areas, basically in underground piping that follow the roadways, and then it comes to the individual laterals. The laterals are the individual pipes that are laid on top of the ground that have the spray heads attached to them. The land application of wastewater research occurred here in the early 60s, here at Penn State. There were some research areas that were set aside for trying it, trying different application rates, trying different things relative to, because it was a new technology back then. We think it's a very sustainable way of treating our wastewater. The land area that we're spray irrigating on, the living filter actually acts as a treatment system in itself. And the fact that it actually treats that wastewater further after it's spray irrigated, it takes about a year to get down to the groundwater. So what we're doing essentially is we're replenishing the groundwater, since the groundwater that the Central Region relies on, and also the groundwater that Penn State relies on.